Strand Pilates, and today we're going to go over feet and straps. So it's an exercise that can be very easy if done incorrectly, and pretty hard if you're doing it really right. So we're going to have two red springs. I'm going to keep my headrest up, and I'm going to lie down on the back. All right, I'm going to put my feet in the straps. Always make sure the strap is nice and snug by the heels. Okay, so we're going to start, make sure you're not squished against the shoulder blocks with those shoulders. We're going to start with your legs up to the ceiling. Your starting position is different for everybody. So you do want to have your neutral spine. So the tailbone's down, the ribs are down, and you have a little space underneath your lower back. If your tailbone is coming off the carriage like this, it means you've gone too far with the legs, so push the legs down until you feel that tailbone anchored. From here, we're going to focus on the neutral spine. So keeping that little space underneath the lower back, I'm going to pull the belly in to stabilize my pelvis and my lower back. So the back stays super stable throughout. It doesn't move. I'm going to squeeze my legs tightly together, and I'm going to unlock my knees. So I don't want a super straight leg, just a slight little bend in the knees. All right, from here, I'm going to keep the belly engaged. I'm going to bring my legs down to 45 degrees and then back up to 90. So again, depending on what your range of motion is, only bring your legs up as high as you can keep the tailbone down, and only bring the legs down as low as you can keep the ribs down. So you don't want to do this. See how the ribs are lifting up? You want to keep the spine super stable, and what's going to help with that is your core strength. So this is leg lowered, and we can transition into leg circles. So the point of this exercise is to keep the hips super stable. If they're rocking from side to side, I'm exaggerating, but if they're rocking from side to side like this, it means that you should make the range of motion a little bit smaller. Same thing, pelvis is not rocking back and forth like this. It's staying super stable. So we're really isolating the legs here from the hips. Lower back doesn't move. And then, of course, you can change the directions. And I love these because they really stretch out your legs at the same time as you're working a lot of things here. You can always pay attention to your feet. If your toes are pointing straight up to the ceiling, that means that you're not externally rotating from your hips. If you want an external rotation, you can turn your toes out and just keep them out the entire time. You can also have your toes in and your heels out. And these just work the legs just a little differently, different spots working. Then we have the frog for our inner thighs. Here we're going to squeeze the heels together, toes apart. I'm bringing my legs down about 45 degrees, keeping my neutral spine. I'm going to bend the knees in just over the hips. Then I'm going to squeeze those heels tight and then press my legs out, wrap those inner thighs tightly together, and then bend them back in. Press out, wrap them tight, and bend them back in. And you're squeezing those heels as tight as you can, like you're holding a coin there between those heels, or a check for $1 million, if that's more motivating. And same thing here, as the legs move, I don't want that pelvis to rock like this. I want to keep that nice neutral spine. All right, that's feet and straps, a couple exercises from it. But again, there's so many awesome things that you can do.